Hello and welcome to Channel B. It's Thursday the 29th of January. Oh, isn't this year flying by? But it is a Thursday, which means it's music day, and on Channel B today, we've got Carl and Pete from The View. Welcome to the show, guys. You having a good day today?
Do you know what I've done today? Before you tell me about your day, do you know what I've done today? I've gone to Downing Street today. I didn't just do that for you. I've been to 10 Downing Street today, but I can't talk about it because, you know, what goes on in 10 Downing Street has to stay.
To be honest, I couldn't hear clear what was going on. It didn't slightly interest me.
Well, you would do actually, because we had a discussion today about science, and I met Sir David Attenborough.
Yeah.
And out of all the people to meet, that's a pretty good person to meet, isn't it? Oh, yeah.
That's
you're ringing. Anyway, what have you been doing today, Carl?
Spot these like things, eh?
Right. So what is that? Musical glove?
Switch that phone off for a second. Like the stamp on it is fucking ancient, anyway.
Give us a tune. You've been out shopping today, right? And this is what you bought. Tracksuit and these gloves. This is the new direction for The View.
You feel that?
Clearly take a little while to get the hang of those.
Right, anyway.
Let's do that.
Switch it up. Switch it up.
Hang it off.
There we go, no.
Can you get a jobby find the off button for you?
First of all, don't forget we've got the highlights of the midweek football down there. You can look at that. I wasn't far off with the prediction for West Brom, was I, JD? I said 7, it was 5. Okay. Also, since we've been Twittering the weekend, we thought we'd come up with a new gag about it. We've been calling it If Twitter had been around, and we put the first one up there in window 2, and I've got a little clip of it here for you. Do you Twitter? Do you Twitter at the moment? You are on Twitter?
No, yeah. I don't care about that. I thought you were on a bit Twitter in general, man.
No. It's a new thing, Twitter, where you update your status. You're not doing that, no?
No, fuck no. So I'd be in a lot of trouble if I only knew what I was doing, man, eh?
Probably right. Let's get on to your right. You've got your new single out and your new album out, both coming out on Monday.
Right, I don't care how they're both coming out on Monday. That's a bit stupid.
Yeah, why are they both coming out on Monday?
I don't know.
Will you just go straight for
the
album?
I don't care. It's something to do with it. I'll be skint. What is it, the credit crunch or something? It's something to do with that fucking. You download it, it's a bit of pound, you bet it's a bit £4, so it's fucking. Do you get it,
So, the album's called Witch Bitch, and the single is called Shock Horror, and we've got a little bit of it here for everyone to see. Here you go. With a little bit of shock, shock horror. Top guys, we put the whole video down there in Windows 7. We see the album's got a vinyl release. Is that true?
No. Don't know, do you?
It's only getting released on vinyl, eh? Because of the credit crunch, man.
Because of the credit crunch, yeah. Okay, some bands record their albums in LA or somewhere glamorous. You chose Wales, did you?
No, because we're banned from pretty much everywhere.
You're banned from everywhere?
We're blacklisted for Japan. We're not allowed back into America. So Wales, Wales seemed the obvious choice.
Are you really not allowed in them?
No, man. You're not allowed.
Not allowed.
We've still got a chance to get back into America, but Japan's completely fucked.
Forever.
And that was the best. We felt like the fucking Beatles there, I swear to God, man. Pure Fred Perry t-shirts, pure thrown at your puss every second of the day. Pure belts, pure fish food.
And is there a period you're not allowed in, or is it forever?
No, forever, right?
Forever
bad? No. McCartney done 30
years.
What'd
you do? Can I ask?
Been bad boys.
Okay. Alright, well, clearly can't ask, they
can. Yeah, can I show you like something on YouTube? Wait, is that part of like, the idea?
We can, let's go to something else and then you can get it and show us, okay, when we go to V2. But what is it? Is it a good thing?
It's that's not... me at Primal Scream gig in 2006, jumping off this big fucking railing.
We'll do that.
I don't want to show
we'll just get on with a few other things first. Paolo Nutini doing guest vocals because he's working next year in the studio, is that right?
Yeah.
Get on well with him?
Nice, good
vibes. Top.
Yeah?
Right.
Good time.
It's just we were in Mono Valley and Rockfield's just like right across the road from it.
Right.
So we heard that he was recording there. So Kyle just went across and says, do you want to come listen to our stuff? And then he had a tune that he says, oh, you want to try a vocal on it? And it was just that. Like that happened like that. It's pretty cool actually.
It's good, right? Because he's a big stoner, right? And we were all like pissheads. I mean, so like he just comes in and has sort of crew coming in there, like on the trumpets and trombones or whatever. And they're coming up like, alright boys, and we're hanging off the ceiling upside down. Pure, alright man, let's do it man. And it's pure, like, trying not to intimidate them. And I'm going, fucking Abdi, settle down man, I'm not being funny, but you're fucking intimidating them.
I was intimidating them, eh? It wasn't you that was hanging up upside down for the...
Exactly, I was putting it in pure mono up on the rafters, man. Pure, no, I'm afraid of heights, eh? Pure, I'm like, that's fair enough, man, I'm not saying you're geared, man. But shit up.
Good, well that's good. Right, you're touring, aren't you? When's the tour start, do you know?
7th.
7th, okay. Yeah. And also with this, which is it, with the DVD, with the CD comes a DVD of your footage from...
From when we started.
From when you
been,
started.
Like, we've been had, like, this boy called Julian that's been following him a bit for, like, dribs and drabs like, at a time, and he's just been collecting all this footage and he's just edit it, and it's like kind of a, before we released the first album to right now.
Is it mad watching? Do you remember the stuff when you watch it back?
Somebody could have told us, like, I used to hear it, didn't feel like my arse or anything, like, but that was mental, it was just weird. Look, aged. Well, aged.
I used to look like fucking Mick Fleetwood in my early days, man. You know what I mean? What I mean? That's not a very good progression, man. You know what I mean?
I think we got a clip here, have we? This is you mucking about with a fish, I believe.
I feel going to slap somebody like, no me.
We were getting interviewed for in Stornoway, right? And we were playing in this tuck shop.
It was an experiment for the independent
I was like, oh, it was really, really bad, man. So we got this guy for, like, the Times or whatever.
Times or something.
And we went up to get this picture taken in the north of Scotland, and we just came across all these magic mushrooms.
Tons, thousands and millions, man.
And that's what happened. That's the result that night.
Fish and violence.
But like, the thing was, man, we gave the boy for the fucking the Times some of them as well. So he gave a good review
as well.
But if you watch it, it's probably the most humiliating, shittiest, just pure degrading thing we've ever done. I was a community centre. I was under 15s. I was in front of 30 people. You weren't allowed to drink. You were only allowed diet drinks. No sweeties in the tuck shop. Fuck up. Like, pure, we had to play, and I was going, fuck us, we were going to save the mushrooms for on the tour, right? And I says, come on, let's do them, I can't handle them, man. This is the most nervous I've ever been. The bairns are intimidating, man. So I says, fuck it, man, I'm going out. So we swallowed the mushrooms, obviously it didn't work, made a c*** of myself. But still, we got a great review for the boy, man.
Well, that's good. So what is your, you're out touring, what... in this country or Britain, what's the best gig? Is it for you going to somewhere like Glasgow? Is that...